Hello everybody and welcome to another edition of Fuzzy Fractals Polycraft. I'm going to show you some of the stuff we've been working on lately and maybe do a little work on it. We'll see how I feel. Over in Nan's house, doing some stuff over in this area. And in the last video I posted, we were working on this barn, which I think is pretty much done. And that's a lot of horses. That's a lot of horses. Yeah. That's a horse of a different color and all that. Copyright infringement. So I like it. Kind of matches with the path he was doing up there, which was not the original intention, but it works pretty nicely. It would be really nice if there were nether brick fences. Maybe one day. We can only hope. The real thing that we've been working on, though, which is a project that I spearheaded, which was the plan, was to build some sort of temple. We're going back and forth between temple, village, something else, not really sure. I just kind of said, let's just build a temple of sorts, and it turned into a gigantic temple. It's funny how that happens. You know, the wall was already here, so I had to fill in the wall area, so this is what I did, and I'm pretty happy with it, but it still needs some more work. This is something that I've never tried to really do before, is like these sort of carvings in the facade using stairs, but I think it looks really cool. Doesn't that look like the Space Invaders, sort of? A little bit. I tried to kind of vary them, not make two the same, but then, you know, in the front-facing facade, it sort of made sense to make it symmetrical. And then added quartz on the top. Originally it was just all sandstone, because, I mean, in order to build something this big, I kind of had to process my way through it. So everything was originally out of sandstone, and then kind of I've been working on sort of backfilling with other materials as appropriate. And again, it ends up being quartz and nether brick, just like all the stuff over there, which is all quartz and nether brick. And, yeah, Nanasin and Marie have built some nice minarets on the side, which look quite lovely and kind of finish off the temple effect, I think. So, yeah, originally this was all sandstone, and then I started with the quartz in the corners, and then I was like, well, that doesn't look right, so let's do one quartz on each side of the corner. And I was like, well, that still doesn't look right, let's do one nether brick on each side. Now I'm kind of thinking, as I'm looking at this some more, there should really be another thing of quartz in the middle. Otherwise, it just looks kind of silly. So that's what we're going to try to do now. We're going to kind of evaluate how it looks. And yeah, the quartz is just a big pain to get a lot of quartz together. But the advantage is you get a nice bunch of experience with the quartz. So let's see if I kind of round this out a little bit more. I think it's a little bit of an abrupt change between the sandstone and the nether brick, so I'm gonna transition in, transition darker, transition lighter, and then this is kind of our medium tone. I wonder if I should put another layer of quartz down this one. Well, let's just stick with that for now, because I don't have that much quartz on me, and probably going on a quartz hunt would not be very entertaining for you guys, should anybody choose to actually watch this. Okay, so that's a subtle change. I'm still sort of trying to work through what to do with all these open spaces I've left. Built in a pretty geometrical style, but left a lot of space opening for what should be filled in later. And I don't know, maybe I should just do all glass? Maybe? I don't know. Glass or, you know, I could do, like, patterns with, like, lapis and emeralds or something like that and do a cool pattern, but it's also very expensive to do that, you know, material-wise. So, and I can't put a torch there because it's a stair. Which, that's annoying, they should fix that. Should be able to put a torch on a stair. Though it's helpful because the monsters can't spawn on the stairs anyway, so it's not that critical. Then we're going to go up here and kind of look from afar. And I've switched back. I'm using the Faithful 32 texture pack now. I don't think the OCD texture pack is really great for the videos. Because if you don't know what the textures look like in that texture pack, it might be visually confusing. So, well, you can't really see the difference much from up here. You know, if you compare this side without the interior quartz to that side with the interior quartz, I can't see the difference from here. So, yeah, let's try putting another thing of quartz on the interior border there on the bottom of the triangle. I think otherwise it's not going to quite pop like I want it to. Just enough quartz left to do that. And then maybe, yeah, have to save the rest for another day. Oh, any suggestions anybody out there has about what to fill in these blank spots with in a way that makes the building look, you know, as a consistent composition? That would be pretty helpful, because I'm kind of stumped. As far as the interior goes, yeah, I was just going to do pillars like this, but maybe we can even make it kind of Greek and do columns, proper columns with the quartz. That could be cool. That's going to take so much quartz, and I don't want to use a lot of quartz on all that stuff, and yeah, how much quartz is it going to take before this thing's done? Who knows? Anyway, yeah, that got me thinking. Maybe I should just... The corners seem like they should be fully cornered. Oop, not like that. Yeah. See, that sort of is gonna have some effect on what I choose to put in these areas, depending on how I do... Yeah, how I do... The pillars will affect how I'm gonna do this top part, because maybe I'm gonna need to do... I don't have a single piece of sandstone that I can demonstrate. Maybe in here. Sandstone, 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 sandstone! I don't need the wood. So, because that pillar is like that. Yeah. And then it would have to be the same. Everything has to be symmetrical or else I go crazy. So, could maybe work, but even still, I don't like the transition, so I would even... My gut would tell me to do it like that, and then that makes these even smaller. But, God, now I have to undo that, because it's going to mess things up if it's not... If I don't keep it symmetrical as I'm building it, I'm going to lose track of what needs to be where and how it needs to all work together. So it needs to have, you know... What's done on this side should be, I feel, reflected on this other side. I don't like it. This whole structure was built with symmetry in mind. Not symmetry in that every side is the same. I've actually taken great pains to make each atrium of the temple slightly different. And this is actually the part I am most pleased with, because, you know, we were talking last time, or one of my last videos, about how nothing I ever build ever has a curve in it, because I can't wrap my mind around how to do it, but this time I went for it, did kind of some kind of curve. This is sort of like a sanctuary. There should be like an altar, or, you know, some kind of like Maurice Church, but in a more grand way. That could be cool. And the other thing I was thinking about doing, and I was hoping to recruit some people to help me with, was now that we can do carpet, which is a pretty cool addition. You could do, like, carpeting patterns on the floors, you know, some geometrical sort of back and forth, things that make it look kind of, maybe like sort of things that look like a Persian rug or something like that, you know, temple-y, carpeting. So that might be in the works. I think that would look pretty cool. Because otherwise this thing is kind of, like, kind of colorless. There's not really any color in it, except for black and white and sandstone. So, let's see, did I make those stairs? No, I didn't. Come on. I already did make some stairs. Well, it's all going to be stairs at some point. will have to be quartz mining time once again. Is that consistent on all sides? Alright, now let's go look at that. Let's see if I can jump the fence here. Whee! Nope. That did not work. I think the minarets are cool. That was a good idea. Though, it should be one higher. With one less on top. Can't really articulate why, but it's not quite the right. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I hear a creeper, and I saw him. No, you shall not pass. Die. Oh, okay. Or don't die. Did I get some sandstone out of that at least? That would be really nice. I should probably put a torch down here now. There you go. As long as he doesn't get anywhere near anything we've built over here, it's fine. Creeper holes for the win. Let's go back up. And I really like the lamppost that Corey did. And I think his plan is to have them go all the way up this path eventually. Obviously, it's a burden on materials. You still can't really tell. But maybe, you know, if we can add some glowstone or hide some... Yeah, because there has to be... You know, the top should be glowstone or... some other kind of bright material so that, you know, looks like holy. Looks like a holy temple. Holy temple! We've been building you for far too long. Oh, when will you be done? Thank you. Thank you very much. So, it's a little bit better. I don't want to place the glowstone up there yet, because... I don't want to waste my silk touch any more than I have to. So, since we're basically out of quartz, I don't know what else to do with you guys. Quartz hunt time. Dun, 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 dun. And yeah, last time, about a week ago, I was fixing a small part of the railway between our 00 portal and Lisa's portal, and I forgot that most of Lisa's, you know, path is directly over lava in the Nether, and I went to just make the rails less, how do I describe it? I don't like the rails when they go up. I like it when there's a smooth slope going up, so I was just removing one block to make it a smooth upward motion. And I jumped right through a hole, and that hole led down a very long drop directly into lava, and I lost everything I had on me, including like 3 stacks of obsidian that was going to go to the arena that I haven't checked on in a while. I would assume they're still working on, but they were trying to build it out of obsidian. That might be a little crazy, but it's not really my project, so I will... donate obsidian someday to it. Yeah. Let's hope we don't run into any too bad baddies this way. Yeah, it was this part, but on the other side it was like one block and then one block of flat rail, and right underneath something like this was just a big pit, big drop. Of course, it's been so long since I witnessed them build it, back when I was still watching Polycraft and not playing with the Polycraft crew. It just totally slipped my mind. And I broke the never dig straight down rule in the worst possible location. Yeah, kind of, when I'm walking through the temples, I kind of have a first-person shooter style of doing it, because, I don't know, maybe just years of playing Counter-Strike and stuff, I'm like, you know, gotta look both ways, gotta peek and then run. And sometimes old habits die hard. We haven't done anything more with this over in this area, really. I was hoping maybe someone else will build something over here. Let's see. Mostly I've been taking quartz from up there, but it's probably not technically within Lisa's area. So I think we found out that Uber's building up here is slightly over the Lisa land area. But there's plenty of quartz to grow around, so I'm just not going to worry about it. If I get yelled at, oh well. Too bad. I'm a rebel. And my cause is quartz. So yeah, been slowly working my way into this area with some good quartz patches. Probably not the only one who's doing this either. Feather falling! Yay! Let's see how far. Yep, there's my marker over this way. Another marker over there. So easy to get lost. I'm not gonna bother with those up there. That doesn't look like a big amount up there, so I think I got this far. There's not too much over here except a giant drop down there into lava. No lava! Oh, and by the way, I am recording this with my brand new cheapo headset, which is still hopefully gonna be better than the microphone in my laptop. Definitely better than the microphone in my laptop. I was doing a little testing, and it's yeah, it's much better. I agree. He likes it too. Who wouldn't? You get to hear my lovely voice in stereo. Actually, probably not in stereo. Oh, I missed this before. That's a nice little bit. Now, should I bother still touching it? I have my fortune pick on me. No. No reason to use hits on two picks. Though, I'd be upset if I lost some of this quartz or something. No, it's too much of a pain in the butt. Up there. Try to go for the low-hanging quartz. There's some. Do I have anything to make a cairn out of? Oh, kinda. Ooh, that's good. I'll take it. Thank you. Come again. Okay, no. Try not to waste a single hit on these pickaxes. Oh, I'm already up to 30 levels, so maybe I should silk touch it out so I don't waste experience. Yeah, I might do that, because I'm so close now. And who knows, I could die and then lose 30 levels, and that would be terrible. It would be very upsetting. That looks like a good bit. Ooh, I like this little room. Yeah, silk touch. No, don't waste the hits on those. Yeah, I like the netherrack just like pops like popcorn when you have the efficiency on the pick. Excuse me. I'm already about to get lost if I go that way. Where am I? Let's orientate myself a little bit. Okay, so this is the way. Get out of my way. Yeah, that way's the way back. No lava. No lava. No lava. Get away. I'll put a care in here. One dirt block is enough to know that that's the right way, because, you know, I'm not going to find any other dirt blocks around here. So, let's see, where am I going to go here? Oh, I hate it when my inventory's all full up like that. That's a good little bit. Excuse me, I'm sorry, guys. Shall I dare to go this way? Why not? Let's see what's over this way. Get thoroughly lost. Ooh! I like this. This is always nice. I've been doing good on glowstone lately because of this. Though I'm always tempted to use fortune, but I was told it's still more efficient to, still more efficient to use the self-touch than it is to use fortune on it. I'll take their word on that. Even though I need to give something up here. Here, this is what I can do. I still end up with 3, so it didn't help at all. What can I get rid of? I can get rid of a whole stack of netherrack. That's fine. Go away. Whoa! Oh my god, I'm gonna die. Well, now I'm thoroughly lost, ladies and gentlemen. Where did I just go? Oh my god, ooh. That's probably a new nether fortress. Where the heck am I? 650, 121. That's not my territory. That's not... But, you know. We will let whosoever territory that is know about that. I shouldn't even be over here, and I shouldn't be mining quartz. I'm bad, but... Yeah, there's plenty of quartz to go around. Oh, hi. That was pretty weird. That was kind of scary for a second, guys. Yeah, I'm gonna die now, whee! Ugh, I'm gonna be totally full up. Yeah. Stop hitting the netherrack. Yep, full up again. Oh. I'll just do this. I hate that full inventory. It always seemed to be like that for me. Where did I fall from? Up there? Okay. I'll never make it home again. I'll be lost forever in the nether. Oh, lost forever in the nether. Okay. Yeah, I meant to make that rhyme. I can't wait, guys, for there to be a way to name our horses. I saw that they're going to add some kind of name tag system. Because it would be really cool to have a horse named Shadowfax or something like that. Oh, I'm looking forward to that. Give the horses a little bit more personality. They're pretty cool. As I said in the last video, I was skeptical. Oh, okay. Well, might as well just keep doing it. Who knows? When I get up to 30, I'll stop. See if I can find my way back, guys. And that's not the way back. Whoa, my god. My motor skills are not at their best right now. God, what the f- Oh, that was scary. Okay, I must have been this way that I came from, sort of. Up there somewhere. So let's follow this way back. Oh. I can live with that. That's a nice little bit right there. Let's not be below the point at which we're picking stuff. In case there's lava. My full inventory, I'll end up throwing something valuable into the lava. While I try to get out this. Okay. Let's see, can I get back up there without dying? Probably not if I use sand there. Let's see, this is going to be a little bit delicate. Ugh. This is like parkour. I don't like that. Ugh, I get super paranoid when it's only one block of difference. Let's get this stuff. This looks good. Okay. Oh. Bye-bye. Not even gonna play with that. Oh, I saw a lava drip right there, so we're not gonna play in that direction either. Alright, this looks a little bit more familiar. Where did I come from? Oh, I know where we are now. We made our way back. Good. Where can we find more quartz where we don't have to wander quite so far? Because that was sketchy, guys. I could have been lost. Or killed. Could have been killed! I just want to fight all these guys. Take them all on. Die a glorious death on video. None of my deaths on video so far have been very glorious. The Ender Dragon battle was, I don't think I hit the Ender Dragon once the whole time. That's, you know, the first time for me ever really doing it. I tried to do it in single player, but when you have that platform spawned all the way out in the middle of nowhere, not on the main end, area. It freaked me out and I couldn't deal with it. I'm jumped into the end portal for the first time ever and I'm just like armed to the teeth and I've got like 600 stacks of arrows and just super pumped, and then I get there and I'm like, oh my god, what am I gonna do? And then I looked at an Enderman and was swiftly bonked into the void. So it was a little traumatic. And I haven't been as keen on, I noticed that the lava dissipates much more quickly than it used to. I will risk my life and limb, see if that is actually the case still. Let's see if I can pillar my way up there without getting too close here. And see how fast the lava dissipates, because there's some good quartz down there. Okay. So maybe a little faster than it used to be. Go away. I need this quartz. Stop burning things. Lava. Lava. I suppose I could speed the process along a little bit. I might die. So maybe not a lot faster than it used to be. Oh god. Run away! Yeah, I'm gonna have to come back for that. Okay, that made it way worse. Good job. Hey, it's all a learning experience, isn't it? If I stood here for like an hour, eventually I would have some quartz down there. But it's just not worth it right now. I kinda wanna see what's down there, but I kinda know already that it's lava. When in doubt, it's lava. I want that. That's over lava. Damn near close to it. Gold! Hooray for gold. Hey, language. Recording over here. Not that I really care. In fact, I don't really know what the rules are on YouTube if you're just gonna license it under a Creative Commons license or whatever, you're not expecting to make any money off of it or anything like that. I don't know, is it okay to use profanity in that case? I don't really know. I don't know what the rules are, I don't know if I would get flagged or reported or something if I dropped a bunch of F-bombs. Which, honestly, everything is really made better with profanity. I mean, yeah, everything. I agree with that. So I would like to use profanity. There are times when I probably am playing Minecraft where I couldn't even help it. Oh god. Oof. All the sweat pores on my body just activated themselves for a split second there. definitely is a biological reaction to falling in this game that probably closely resembles the biological reaction if I was actually falling in real life. I don't know if that's like a motor... What do they call it? Motor neuron? No. Mirror neurons. I don't know if it's one of those kind of things. I don't know if anybody knows what I'm talking about there. But yeah. This is a good little cachet over here. I like it. I should be more careful about jumping down into things, though. Okay. Well. Always with the two remaining, super annoying. That's only one stack of quartz, though, so that's realistically only, like, really one stack of quartz bricks. You just really need to just mine the crap out of it. And it's just no quarter. I don't care about borders. Take no prisoners. Find all the quartz. How far does that drop? Now I can saunter my way down more gracefully than that. Whee! Whee! I'm gonna get super lost, though I know Uber's shack is just over yonder. If I was had a... Yeah, there it is. So... I'm gonna quartz it up some more. And my apologies for not doing something more interesting than mining quartz. But I can't do anything in the temple without more quartz. It seems clear to me at this point. That is just gonna be... I mean, for a while it was like I couldn't do anything with it without more sandstone. So now it's quartz's time, and eventually I'll have to do the same thing with the... with the nether brick. And whatever else we decide to build this... build it out of, so. I hear gurgling. The gurgle of the lava. Can you hear that? It's the sound of the lava. Thank you. Okay. Yeah. Am I gonna lose my sense of direction here? It's that way is home. So, let's try to not get uber lost by Uber's house. I must say, all the people on this server just generally seem like a really nice group of people. It's always really nice when you kind of end up randomly put together with people and you end up really liking them. It's not a common thing in this world to find like-minded people. And it's also quite a diverse group of people, too. Everybody seems to have a different background and range of experiences, and it's nice to... always nice to meet people different than yourself and expand your worldview and all that hippy-dippy philosophy. And yes, in fact, I do live in a hippie town, so yes, I have internalized some of those touchy-feely... philosophies into my life. After, let's see, I've lived here. I'm not gonna reveal where exactly, but you can guess that it is a university town with a large collection of various alternative lifestyle like people are quite common. So with that comes a lot of the touchy-feely side of things, which I'm okay with, you know. I'm a sensitive guy. I don't mind talking about the feelings and all that stuff. So why won't you pick this one up? Thank you. But yeah, I mean, I grew up definitely on the East Coast where, you know, people don't talk except to be like, hey, you're stepping on my feet. What you gonna do? I'm gonna cut off your legs and stuff like that, so... Moving out here to the west was a change of pace in a lot of different ways for me. But it's been a good thing, because I've been mellowed a lot since my younger years. As most people do. Am I lost now? Am I lost? I could be lost. It's that way. Okay. Maybe I should put down a Karen. What else can I tell you about the hippy-dippy philosophy? I probably shouldn't go that much into it. I might reveal too much about where I live. Don't really think I should do that. So, yeah. Oh, this is just a gold or a quartz mine over here, and a glowstone mine, but my inventory is just getting super filled up. I'll just use this cairn. That'll solve that issue. That looks like a really nice bit over there, but it might be over lava. I don't like taking unnecessary risks just for a few good materials. I've almost reached a half an hour, though, so try to cut the videos at a length that is not ridiculous. Now I know a good place to come back to for later in this direction. It's definitely a good direction. Pretty much any place that no one has ever been before in the Nether is a good direction. Might be enough quartz for like a little bit. Just know I'm gonna burn right through it. Let's see if this... That is just awesome right there. Is this lava down here? Oh no. That's safe. That's definitely safe. It's gonna take me like 2 tries to get all of it, so I'm gonna have to do 2 pillars here. Probably. Let's see if I get to the center of it. I don't even have a good material to pillar up with at this point. I'm gonna have to take this back. I need this. I'm not even gonna be able to get that high up with just 9 blocks of this and... I could use wood. Yeah, I might have to. Then get rid of that. Just... I don't want to use wood. I don't have an axe. This is stupid. Okay. What should I do here? Well, I could make a chest. Now we're going to think very creatively here, guys. I'm going to make a chest. And throw away all that stuff. And then we're gonna put some of these. I can get rid of that. I don't care too much about that. This, I wanna keep those close by. I need all. What can I really realistically get rid of here? Oh, I did have an axe. There. Okay, well, that helps a little bit. I'll put the wood in there too, because I don't need that. Okay. Well, that still didn't really help my issue here. Yeah, I'm gonna need a lot more than 12. Come on, Andrew, use that brain. Brain good. Brain good, dumb bad. Okay, yeah. We're reaching the end of this video, I think. But this is just such a sweet bit right here. It's highly lucrative in the glowstone department. Oh, look at that. I can even... Man, I'm gonna be so upset when I lose the soap touch right here. Go back to lame fortuning out glowstone, stuff like that. It's not fun. Not as fun. Yeah. You know, I could just jump over. That seems really dangerous. But no, I have the feather fall. I think this is perfectly safe. As long as my hand-eye coordination holds up. I might die. I hate dying. Oh my god. Breathe. It's okay. Just don't move forward. Don't touch anything. And you'll be all good. Oh, I want all of it. I should just leave what is not realistically possible to get and be satisfied. that's a good little bit, and I don't get quite all of it. Meh. There are easier places to get glowstone. They're just not quite as sweet as this spot right here. Can I reach that last one there? Can I reach that one if I do this? Come on. Yes. Yes. And this one probably not. Let's see. No, I don't want to do any more than that. I'm just sketching myself out here. And we won't leave the ugliness. Ooh. That's a lot of glowstone. I'll leave it like this. Someone knows Andrew was here. Oh, yeah. Two and a half stacks of glowstone, and 1, 2, 3 and a half-ish stacks of quartz. We'll just do a little bit more quartz here. And call it a day, maybe. Oh, I kind of want to just keep recording right now. But I won't. And I don't think I can get to that without... that's too much of a pain. Next excursion. That's a nice little bit, too. That's a nice big chunk. We'll go home now. Wear out the feather falling boots when it's not necessary. Okay, they may move well. Ouch. It didn't even take off anything. See, just the thorns. Ugh, I don't like the thorns. It's just... I got this nice protection for armor, and I've gone through it so fucking quickly because of the thorns. And, I mean, it's probably useful for PvP situations, but... I don't need a, like, extra bonus against whenever I'm doing melee combat against a zombie. Whether it takes 3 hits with the sword to kill the zombie, or 4 hits to kill the zombie, you know, I'm not gonna die, you know, in the time between the second and third hit. So the thorns is really kind of pointless, in my opinion. Something that I've bitched about many a time. Oh, I said that. Yep. Hopefully that doesn't count as profanity to say that. I guess it depends on what your definition is. Yep. I don't know if you guys could hear that, but there's some people outside my apartment yelling. Carrying on a Friday. Well, this is my carrying on, I guess. Yep. Still not as bad as Mad Jin with the clear sounds of a busy city street on some of his videos. Pretty quiet neighborhood. If it wasn't for the people who live in my apartment building, yeah, it's one of those situations where the people who rent the apartments, or who maintain the apartments, they don't own the apartments, but they live in the complex, so they kind of have made it their very homey, which means picnic tables and neighborly things going on. Just a little unusual to actually have basically your landlord living more or less in the apartment right below mine. Hopefully they don't mind me stomping around late at night. Nah, probably not. I'm probably used to it by now. Okay. Let's go back in just for fun. Maybe I'll roll a I'm so low on diamonds, though, I don't even want to roll pick. I have 9 diamonds, or like 7 diamonds remaining total. Probably should mine for diamonds sometime soon. Though other people have offered me to take or borrow some of their diamonds, but I don't like borrowing in real life, so I know how much effort it takes to get diamonds in Minecraft, so that just feels like asking a little bit too much of somebody for them to give me diamonds. Anything else, I would be fine. You know, oh, can I borrow, you know, some quartz or some glowstone or anything like that. But diamonds, too precious to really ask someone to give you some. You know, if someone has a good trade, you know, say, oh, I'll give you a stack of quartz for one diamond, then I'm all for it. But I should really probably do something with these 30 levels. I kinda want another shovel. I actually have another pick. But it has Fortune 2 on it. So I don't really want to use that as a day-to-day. Really, like, for a pick that you're not gonna, you know, you should have three picks. You should have one pick with Fortune of whatever, whatever you can get. One pick with Silk Touch, and one pick that doesn't have either, and just has Efficiency and or Unbreaking. I wish you could remove, but why would you ever want to remove Fortune? That would be bad. Yeah, seven. Yeah, I don't want to use something that has Fortune on it for just, like, daily, you know, removing Netherrack and stuff like that. It's just a waste. So, okay. Let's see, maybe I'll get another Silk Touch. That would be really nice. So, let me just mine out a little bit more of this quartz so I get up to 30. Actually, usually this is maybe kind of superstition on my part, but I've noticed that, yes, the rain needs to go away. I've noticed that if you roll with just 30 levels, I tend to be more disappointed in what I get than if you roll and you have like 31 or 32 levels. It seems impossible from, like, a programming standpoint how it could possibly make a difference whether you had exactly 30 or if you had, like, an extra couple. But in my experience, it definitely seems like superstition. But, I don't know, anything's possible, right? But I'm sure it would be something that would be well known if there was some difference between rolling 30 levels or when you have just 30 levels and rolling 30 levels when you have a couple extra. Anyway, yeah, superstition. But we'll get to 32, and then we'll go roll a pick. Otherwise, I'm kind of wasting my levels here a little bit. Oops. Ah, I got too much stuff. The stuff. Let's put some of this stuff away. Oh, that's full. Okay. Gas tiers. I would really like to keep those somewhere. I don't like the idea that those gas tiers are just hiding in some random chest somewhere. They should be next to a brewing area. I don't like keeping really things that are for specific usage, and I don't like putting things in just random old chest. I did leave that chest in the Nether though there. Oops. Oh well. There wasn't anything of value in it. One blaze rod. I guess that would have been nice to try to keep. Let's make some sticks. Oh, I had that. Ugh, Andrew. Being a little bit kind of dumb today. But at least you didn't die. I do enjoy how well my computer handles recording. I don't really notice any kind of lag or... I guess it's because everything I'm recording is going onto not my operating system. I have my operating system on a solid-state drive, and then my laptop is fortunate enough to actually have a second hard drive bay. So I used the stock hard drive that came with it, which, being a good computer, was a 7200 RPM drive, and I'm just using that for storage, and since it's mostly empty, it's really useful for recording. And super fast, because, yeah, 7200 RPM, that's perfect. That's exactly what I want. Couldn't have asked for anything better than that. I'm very pleased. I mean, efficiency 4, I don't even know if Unbreaking 4 is possible. That's perfect, though, because that's a good everyday use pick. I won't go through that too fast, but it also has, yeah, perfect. I mean, I could combine these together, but what's the point, you know? I mean, if I had one more Silk Touch pick, maybe I would do that. But that is, that makes me very happy, Andrew. So, yeah, I guess I'm just gonna go ahead and fortune up the rest of this, this here quartz, and then keep going with this building, and next time you see it, hopefully it will be in a more completed state. Though, it is pretty close, but it just needs some, like, detailing. Yeah, detailing definitely is the word. So, here's this little part from the outside. I tried to make it have a lot of depth and stuff. Oh, and I didn't even show you the very center of it, which I was complimented on. I'll show you the web real quick. This was not exactly intentional, but this part going up kind of reminds me of the, like, the that extra level in GoldenEye. If anybody remembers the, is it the temple complex level? I can't remember the name of the level now. It's escaping me. But the one with the golden gun. This is kind of what it kind of looks like. This a little bit. Or the temple multiplayer level too, in GoldenEye, which is, yes, we've all played our share of GoldenEye. I actually just recently bought a copy of it off eBay, because I still have my old N64. Much to my little brother's chagrin, because I brought it out here to Colorado, and he always bugs me about when is he going to get his turn with it, because he lives across the country. And my response for him is, you're never going to get it. It's mine. If you want it, you're going to have to come here and take it yourself. And actually, he did come visit me and thought he was going to try to take it, and I said no. So, he's going to have to pay me for it if he wants it. Anyway, that was quite the segue. So, thanks for all you guys for watching, and sorry I spent quite a bit of that time just mining quartz, but I tried to keep it interesting. So, have a lovely rest of your evening, or day, or whatever time of reality you happen to be in as you're watching this, and we will see you next time. Thanks, bye!